Wears on. One popular and safe way to get outdoors has been to hike. But a pair of trails in the East County may be getting a little too popular and complicated. Cleveland National Forest officials announcing the closure of the Three Sisters and Cedar Creek Falls trails now through October. Joining us now to talk about that decision, U.S. Forest Supervisor Scott Tangenberg. Hello there.
Hello, nice to be with you.
Nice to have you here. So can you explain the factors that went into making that decision?
Absolutely, yeah. These are some of the most beautiful locations on the Cleveland National Forest, and we definitely love that we're able to host people out there. Unfortunately, at this time of year, the heat as well as the subsequent risk to people's life and safety are the kinds of things that inhibit our ability to provide a safe opportunity out there. So when we took a look at how many rescues were happening out there, as well as the increased visitation that we're experiencing out there, we didn't take this lightly, but we did move forward with the decision to close these two areas off.
And of course, this year, the pandemic is only making things more difficult. Can you talk about that? What's been happening in terms of people on the trail, social distancing, maybe parking?
Sure, yeah. So both of these areas don't have very much space in terms of places to park. And so because of the pandemic and because people are looking for ways to get out and enjoy nature and get away from others, they're going to natural places like this. And what unfortunately they experience at these two locations is a lot of traffic parked along county and public roads. They experience a narrow trail that funnels people into actually closer proximity to each other, as opposed to someplace like an open park or even the beach.
And what about enforcement? I mean, of course, we don't want to have to think about that, but if there are some people who are either unaware or maybe trying to sneak onto the trails, what will you do to enforce the new rule?
Yeah, our first approach is always education. You know, we're not looking to criminalize visiting the National Forest in any way, shape, or form, but it is our responsibility to do everything we can to not only provide for the safety of our visitors, but also for our staff and our partner emergency response agencies, law enforcement agencies. And so if we have a person who is willfully attempting to disregard this closure area and can potentially get belligerent with our staff, those would be the limits of where we would actually look to exercise some kind of enforcement action. Otherwise, we very much want to be in an education and safety providing mode, just helping people understand what's a good idea and what's a bad idea.
And in the meantime, for folks who still want to get out there, do you have any suggestions where else people can go to get that beautiful scenery if they can't go here right now?
Yes, absolutely. So the couple of factors that make this area problematic is that you have to hike down into the hole, and then in order to get out, it can be very hot, very taxing, and it's what leads to the 45 plus rescues that we've had just since the end of June. So other areas that the National Forest provides are more of a traditional, you start at one elevation and you hike up to another elevation, making that return trip home a lot easier. So places like Mount Laguna, Mount Palomar, San Luis Rey, even as far north as our Tribeca Ranger District in Orange and Riverside County, all of those areas still remain open and all of them can be enjoyed by the public.
We're lucky we still have some other areas that we can enjoy around here. Forest Supervisor Scott Tangenberg, thank you so much for spending some time with us and for clearing that up.
Thank you very much for the invitation.